I would like to see somebody
suggest
say that
something
is natural law that he doesn't agree with.
Right.
I think that we tend to label natural law what we take as self-evident.
One of the things about contemporary universities is also, which you I think do comment about some, but not perhaps enough, is the relentless secularism of the universities, and the this is the kind of thing that Bill Buckley was complaining about 60 years ago in 1951, you know, in God and Man, at Yale. But as it happens, you have said some very interesting and cogent things about yourself being a non-religious conservative, a secular conservative, a skeptical conservative. You've called yourself. And if I may, let me just quote one line from you. You say, the presumption of religious belief, not to mention the contradictory thinking that so often accompanies it, does damage to conservatism by resting its claims on revealed truth. I want to just ask you how serious you are about that and what you mean by that. If you label something based on revealed truth alone, then that takes care of the problem in some sense, doesn't it? I mean, isn't your quarrel with the things that religious conservatives don't describe simply as based on religious revelation, strictly speaking?
I just see invoking a holy writ as a shortcut to argument, because not everybody agrees on the same holy writ. And I think that conservative truths can be arrived at empirically, mm-hmm, by observing what happens when the family breaks down. I believe in male and female parents,
right,
as essential. And I, right, am actually against gay marriage. And it has nothing to do with anything in the Bible, but because I believe that men and women are different, that they each bring, on average, different instincts to child rearing, that they stand for different virtues. Mm-hmm. Again, on average, there's plenty of deeply empathetic, you know, heart-rending males and disciplinarian, mm-hmm, martinet, mm-hmm, mothers. And mothers that are going to,
sure,
go out and,
sure,
take their boy fishing and eat dog food if necessary. But on average, I believe that we can see empirically what happens to culture when marriage breaks down. And I don't need to invoke what is claimed to be the Word of God to make my case.
No, but my only claim really is that for most religious conservatives, well, for many religious conservatives, they don't need the Word of God either.
Exactly.
To make that case.
And I don't think that you need the Word of God to raise civilized children.
But they might
call it...
You
need a sense of habit and virtue,
right,
and discipline.
Exactly. But they might call... I'm wondering whether you don't agree that there is a kind of rational morality that is not strictly dependent on God, which is, I think, the position,
right,
of natural law.
I think the golden rule.
Thinkers of many schools.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
That parents understand this instinctively, that you inculcate in your child a sense of, you don't beat up your little sister, A, because it's going to lead to household chaos, and there's an innate need for order, but B, because your little sister has feelings like you, mm-hmm, do, and you want to have reciprocal moral behavior. And what moral education is about is widening that sphere of empathy and understanding to greater and greater distance in human interaction. But again, that is based on an understanding of the paramount importance of order and self-discipline and respect for others. And I think that, yes, that can be arrived at through reason without a invocation of, to me, what is a rather counterfactual claim about we live with a loving God who cares about every one of us individually when we live with the daily slaughter of the innocents that are mowed down.
No, well, I bring up the question the way I do because it's you who say that non-believers look elsewhere for a sense of order, which I think is true as far as it goes, valuing the rule of law for its transparency to all rational minds. Mm-hmm. And debating Supreme Court decisions without reverting to mystical precepts or natural law, end quote. But I mean, mystical precepts and natural law are two very different things. I mean, as you say just a few sentences later, they do not need, skeptical conservatives do not need God or the Christian Bible to discover the golden rule and see themselves in others. I think that's absolutely true. But I think that's many religious conservatives would concede that the natural law or rational morality is a source of the golden rule.
But I do not. I mean, this is where we're going to maybe disagree with the Straussian background. I'm not convinced about a natural law either, and maybe again this is my deconstructionist background coming up. That I think cultures are very different, and I think our concept.
But your endorsement of the golden rule.
I would like to see somebody
suggest
say that
something
is natural law that he doesn't agree with.
Right.
I think that we tend to label natural law what we take as self-evident.
Yeah. Well, but that includes the golden rule.
Well, I would say for a stable society, that's right. I'm not persuaded that very different tribal cultures that have not achieved our civilizational advance, which I think is something special about Europe and the Enlightenment and the belief in argumentation and needing to justify rules, that they may differ on things in significant ways.
They do, and I'm not sure that admission has anything to do with the notion of natural law as a rational morality, though. I mean, people don't, just because tribes don't understand the Pythagorean theorem doesn't mean that it's not true.
Mm-hmm.
Right? But I guess all I'm saying gently is that you may be committing natural law without realizing it. Insofar as you do think that the golden rule, for example, is something true or something that appeals to seeing ourselves in others, is not a cultural, merely cultural thing.
Yeah, I just see, slavery was justified by the Christian Bible and by natural law. It's just a fact. There were also people who argued against slavery based on Christianity and natural law. It just seems that if I was
on secular grounds and rational grounds
completely,
too.
Completely, absolutely. Yeah. But I've yet to see universal agreement on what natural law is. If I could see that, then I would know that it is truly something innate to all human beings. And what I see is rather evolution. Changing, for whatever reason, it's mysterious how human beings do change their sense of what is natural.
Right.
But, I mean, I'm not a feminist, but so I'm not offended that the founders did not think of having females vote. It doesn't bother me. I don't have a chip on my shoulder. Nevertheless, that is a pretty radical difference. Nobody today, when they were, if they were to create the American Constitution from scratch, would think of limiting suffrage to males. That would be assumed as almost a part of natural law, that males and females should be voting. So I see something that we like to invoke transcendent universal ideals, but I see culture evolving.